Hey y'all, here to talk about different articulations of the body. Articulations, that's just a fancy word for joints. Let's first, in this video, go over synarthrotic joints, synarthrotic articulations, and amphiarthrotic articulations. So synarthrotic, S-Y-N, syn, that means together. So an arthrosis or arthrotic means joint. So a joint that's together. What that means is it's a very, very secure joint. It doesn't move at all. Synarthrotic joints do not move. There are a couple synarthrotic joints that you should know. One is this connection between the frontal bone, or in the frontal bone. So the frontal bone is just one bone in adults, but you can see here that there's this frontal suture. I know it's called a suture, but we don't categorize it as a sutural articulation, a sutural joint. This is a synostosis. It's bone to bone. Other examples of synostoses, ilium to ischium to pubis, the vertebrae that fuse together to form the sacrum, the vertebrae that fuse together to form the coccyx, and also the fusion of what formed the mandible. Those are all examples of synostoses. An example of another synarthrotic joint is the first rib. The first rib connecting to the manubrium of the sternum is different from the rest of these costal cartilages. This costal cartilage to this manubrium, it goes bone, cartilage, hyaline cartilage, bone. Versus here, it's bone, hyaline cartilage, synovial joint, bone. There's more movement on these joints. There's no movement here. The rib one to manubrium is a synarthrotic joint. It would be classified as a synchondrosis. This is synostosis because it's bone to bone. Synchondrosis is cartilage to bone. Another example of a synostosis, I don't have it cut open, but if you were to cut open a long bone, you could see an epiphyseal line. That epiphyseal line would be a synostosis. If it were a plate, if it were still a growth plate and there was still cartilage in between, and the chondral ossification still has yet to occur completely, there's cartilage in between, that would be a synchondrosis. So once again, this frontal suture is not a sutural joint, it's a synostosis. These other sutures, like the coronal suture, sagittal suture, lambdoid suture, squamous suture, these sutures have really, really tiny ligaments between them. Those are known as sutures, sutural joints. They're fibrous. Another joint that's fibrous is the connection between the teeth and the sockets, the alveolar sockets of the maxillae and the mandible. This is called a gomphosis joint. A gomphosis joint is another synarthrosis. So those are all synarthroses. Synostoses, sutures, gomphoses, and synchondroses. Those are all examples of synarthroses. Excuse me. Meaning they don't move a lot. An example of an amphiarthrotic joint, amphiarthrotic means it moves a tiny bit but not a whole lot, would be your symphyses. Symphyses are wherever you have fibrocartilage between two bones directly. So between the bodies of these vertebrae, those are those intervertebral discs, those are amphiarthrotic joints. Those intervertebral joints. The pubic symphysis between the pubic bones, that is an amphiarthrotic joint. It moves a tiny bit, but it does not move a lot. There is a sheet of connective tissue, ligament, a sheet of ligament connecting the radius and ulna, as well as the fibula and tibia. That sheet is meant to stabilize those two bones, and therefore it doesn't move too much. Those are called syndesmoses. the radioulnar syndesmosis and the tibiofibular syndesmosis. Those are also amphiarthrotic. So those are amphiarthrotic joints that move a tiny bit, and then we also went over synarthrotic joints that move, that don't move at all. In another video, we'll go over diarthrotic or synovial joints.